In this video, we investigate the structural behavior of silos and tanks. These two kinds of structures are very similar to each other, but silos contain granular material such as sand, rice, or pellets, while tanks hold liquids. As the first video in this series demonstrated, gravitational forces on liquids and granular materials give rise to horizontal pressures, and these pressures depend on depth. This silo model makes it easy to see and feel the effects of these horizontal forces. When we put the parts of the silo together and fill it with marbles, we can feel the outwards forces and how they are greater near the bottom than at the top. This happens because the pressure inside the silo increases with depth. If we hold the silo together with equally spaced rubber bands and then add marbles, the rubber bands near the bottom stretch more than those near the top because of this pressure gradient. If we put a bag inside the silo, we can fill it with water, thus turning the silo into a tank. As you can see, the bottom again expands because the water pressure is higher there. Instead of placing the rubber bands evenly along the height of a silo, is there a better way to place them? Here is our answer. We concentrated our rubber bands near the bottom, since the pressure is higher there. And, as you can see, the steel reinforcing bands on real silos often follow that same pattern. Tanks experience similar pressure distributions, and their walls are often designed so that the steel or concrete used to make them increases with depth. We hope this video has helped you to better understand how tanks and silos work. To learn more about how soil and water interact with structures, we hope you will view our videos on dams, retaining walls, and tunnels and culverts.